He's saying lay siege to it. He wants them to draw a picture of Jerusalem and then lay siege to it. Do you know what is siege? When someone says, I'm going to lay siege against your city, what they're saying is, you have a city that is surrounded by a protection of wall, of a wall, okay? When God says to lay siege to that city, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to encamp my army around the walls of your city. And therefore, you can't go to the grocery store, you can't go out to get water, you can't do anything. Whatever food you have inside of that wall, that's all you get, because anybody steps out of the wall is dying, because I'm going to place a siege around it, an army around the wall. And so God is telling Ezekiel, this is what I'm prophesying that's about to happen to Israel. And while they're inside of Israel and Jerusalem, he said, this siege is going to cause them to understand that I am fed up with their sin. Understand? How many of you guys know God gets fed up with sin?
Amen.
Okay, you under grace. Don't get it twisted. God got feelings. You keep sinning and then keep coming back. He got, okay, I'm going to place a siege against you, okay? So, this is what he's telling him to do, okay? And he's telling him to do it as a picture, because he wants him to do something, because he's prophesying. He said, then take an iron pan and place it as an iron wall between you and the city, and turn your face toward it. It will be under siege, and you will be sieged. This will be a sign to the house of Israel. Verse 4. Then lay on your left side and put the sin of the house of Israel upon yourself. You are to bear their sins for the number of days you lie on your side. I have assigned you the same number of days as years of their sin. So, for, now listen, he says, the same number of days as years for their sin. So, he says, so for 390 days, you will bear the sins of the house of Israel. So, God is telling him, I want you to go lay on your side for 390 days. Each one of those days is representing a year that Israel is going to be punished for the sin that they committed against me. Now he says, I'm going to write this up here. Are you following me, Pastor Ben? I'm going to write this up here. 390 days. So each one of those days is representing a year. Now he says, after you have finished, verse 6, are you guys with me?
Amen.
After you have finished this, lie down again, this time on your right side, and bear the sins of the house of Judah. I have assigned you 40 days, 40 days, a day for each year. Hallelujah. A day for each year. And turn your face toward the siege of Jerusalem, and with bare arms prophesy against her. I will tie you up with ropes so that you cannot turn from one side to the other until you have finished the days of your siege. Okay? So now, how many days now? 40. Praise God. So now, he lays on his side one way, and then he lays on his side the other way, and God is declaring to the nation of Israel what? You're going to be punished for 430 years. So now Israel is going to be punished, and God has declared it to Ezekiel, you're going to be punished for 430 years. Now, scripture number 2. Let's go to the book of Jeremiah, chapter 25. In Jeremiah chapter 25, verse 11 and 12, he says, the whole country will become a desolate wasteland, and these nations will serve the king of Babylon for 70 years. But when the 70 years are fulfilled, I will punish Babylon, right? Is that what you're saying? And his nations and the land of Babylon for their guilt, declared the Lord. Now, this is what I want you to understand. God is about to punish the nation of Israel for 430 years. But he's going to start this punishment in the nation of Babylon. He's going to send Nebuchadnezzar against the nation of Israel to place a siege around the city and destroy the city and destroy the temple. And the people of Israel are going to spend 70 of those years in Babylon. Okay. They go into Babylon for 70 years. Okay, first 70 years of punishment is about to get started. Let's turn your Bibles to Leviticus chapter 26. See, you will never understand why Israel is back in the land. You'll never understand World War I. You'll never understand the Holocaust or Hitler until you understand that God had a plan. Because he's redeeming the world. And Israel is a big part of that plan. So here you are. You're in Leviticus chapter 26. Okay. In Leviticus chapter 26, let's go to verse 18. It says, if after all this you will not listen to me, I will punish you for your sins seven times over. Let's go down to verse 21. If you remain hostile toward me and refuse to listen to me, I will multiply your afflictions seven times over. Let's go down to verse 23. If in spite of these things you do not accept my correction but continue to be hostile toward me, God's continually talking to Israel here, I myself will be hostile toward you and will afflict you, will afflict you for your sins seven times over. Okay, so is God making this point clear? Yeah. This is the point of God, what he's trying to say. He says, you're going to go into Babylon for 70 years. If you get it together in Babylon, all is good. I can forgive you. For the rest of this, I can forgive you. Because if you repent during those 70 years and you get your act together, I'll be merciful to you. But Israel, if you go to Babylon and start acting like the Babylonians forget that I am your God and you are supposed to be obeying me and my commandments, I'm going to multiply your punishment seven times more. Okay. They go into Babylon and act a fool. They start worshiping Babylonian gods. They start sacrificing their children to idols. They started doing absolutely everything the Babylonians were doing. They completely forgot that their God brought them out of Egypt. So when the 70 years are over, Daniel is, in chapter 9, Daniel is completely praying for his people. It's like, Lord, I know my fathers have sinned, the nations have sinned. Forgive us. The 70 years are about to be over with. But what Daniel doesn't understand is that their disobedience is now going to multiply their punishment 7 times more. So, after they came out of Babylon, they had spent 70 years. So now they have 360 years left of punishment. Now, they're going to get that punishment. You know why? They never repented in Babylon. But God said, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to multiply this times 7. So instead of you having 360 more years of punishment, it's now going to be 2,520 years of punishment before I am done with you, before you will ever have the nation of Israel back as your own possession.